ओके, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस सर।
यस सर।
ओके, सो इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद एनिमल टिश्यूज, राइट? सो इन दैट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड आवर फर्स्ट पार्ट, दैट इज एपिथेलियल टिश्यू, राइट? सो इन दैट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड सिंपल स्क्वामस एपिथेलियम, देन सीरेटेड कॉलमनार एपिथेलियम, देन क्यूबॉइडल एपिथेलियम टिश्यू. ओके, सो दिस ऑल टिश्यूज वी हैव कंप्लीटेड इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास. Then apart from that, we have learnt about muscular tissue. In muscular tissue, again we are having three types. That is striated or skeletal muscles, then smooth or unstriated muscles, then these cardiac muscles. Okay. So these all tissues we have learnt in our previous class. So in today's class, we are going to study about connective tissue. Okay. So as per the name suggests, connective. Okay. So these tissues, they are connected. Okay, so here you can see we are having a picture of connective tissue. Okay, so in this you can see that there is a hand. Okay, that is elbow. Okay, so over there we are having various parts. Okay, so if you check this first one, it is loose connective tissue which is present under the skin. Then B, fibrous connective tissue. Then C, adipose tissue. Then D, cartilage. E, bone tissue, and F1 is the blood. So connective tissue, it protects and support the body. Okay, so whatever our body structure is there, we are having a particular body structure. Okay, so we are having a framework, so that framework is given by bone. Okay, so this connective tissue, it protects our body and it also gives support to our body. Then the cells are loosely spaced and embedded in an intercellular matrix. Now the cells of this connective tissue, okay, the cells which are there in the connective tissue, they are loosely spaced, means there are more space is there in between the cells. Okay, and these all are embedded means they are spreaded in the intercellular matrix. Okay, matrix, it is a fluid like structure, okay, where it is present. The matrix may be jelly like, fluid like, or dense or rigid. Now this matrix, okay, it is jelly like in structure, okay, like jam. Then fluid, that is water type or liquid type. Then dense or rigid, it may be solid also. The nature of matrix differs in concordance with the function of the particular connective tissue. Okay, now this nature of matrix, that is whether the matrix is jelly like or liquid like or solid, it depends on what? Depend on the function of the connective tissue. Okay, now suppose there is a particular function given to connective tissue, so based on that the matrix will be nature of the matrix will be decided. Now this connective tissue, in this we are having various parts. Okay, or various types we can say. So the first one is areolar connective tissue. Second one is adipose connective tissue. The next is compact bone tissue. Then next is hyaline cartilage tissue, and the last one is blood cells. Okay, so these are the again different types of connective tissue which we are going to learn. So first one is areolar tissue. So here you can see the picture of areolar tissue. Okay, areolar tissue, it fills the space inside the organs and supports internal organs. So this areolar tissue, what it does, it fills the space. Okay, now there are some space are there in between the organs, inside the organs. So this areolar tissue, what it does, it fills the organs inside and it gives support to the internal organs. So in our body there are so many organs are there, so these all organs, okay, they are supported by the areolar tissue. Next, it helps in repair of tissues. Now what is the main function of areolar tissue? It helps in the repair of the tissues. Next, it is found between the skin and muscles, around blood vessels and nerve, and in the bone marrow. Now where it is found, this areolar tissue, it is found between skin and the muscle. So when you see your skin, okay, so this upper layer, it is called as skin, and below that some muscles are there. Okay, so areolar tissue, it is present between the skin and muscle. Then it is present between the blood vessels. Now in your body, so many blood vessels are there. Okay, and nervous tissues, okay, they all are there. Then the bone marrow. Okay, so at that places, areolar tissue is present. Next is adipose connective tissue. So here you can see the picture of adipose connective tissue. They are the fat storing tissues which are filled with fat globules. Okay, so now when you look at this picture, okay, so see here, these are like spherical in structure or round in structure. Okay, they are round or spherical in structure. So these are called as this white color thing, these are called as fat globules, okay, or fat cells. Sorry, these are called as fat cells. Now these fat cells, as the name suggests, they are responsible for storing the fats. Okay, so these all, they store the fats. These tissues are found below the skin and between the internal organs. Now where these adipose connective tissues are found? These adipose connective tissue, they are found below the skin, okay, and in between the internal organs. Due to the storage of fats, it acts as an insulator. Now you can see that these cells, they are storing the fats. If the fats are present, they act as an insulator. Insulator means they supply the heat to the body. They maintain an optimum temperature of the body. Okay, so these fat cells, they act as an insulator. And why they act as an insulator? Because they store the fats. Now moving to the next part, that is compact bone. Here you can see the structure of compact bone. Okay, this is a cross section of a bone tissue. Now it forms the framework which also anchors the muscles and supports the main organs of the body. So as I said, our body is having a particular structure, it is having a particular posture. Okay, that is a particular shape is there. Now why it is having a shape? Because we are having a framework, and that framework is nothing but the skeleton. Okay, so in our body, skeleton is present. Because of that, we are having a particular structure. It also anchors the muscle. Okay, now these bones, they are connected or they are attached with the muscles, and along with that, it supports the main organs of the body. So there are so many bones are there which protects the organs. Okay, now there are some bones are there which protects the organ. For example, ribs. Okay, ribs protects the heart. Okay, it protects the heart as well as the lungs. Next, it is a strong and non-flexible tissue. Now this compact bone, okay, that is compact bone connective tissue, they are very strong tissues. Okay, they are very strong tissues and non-flexible tissue. Non-flexible means you cannot bend them. They don't have flexible quality. Okay. Bone cells are embedded in a hard matrix that is composed of calcium and phosphorus compounds. Now these bone cells, okay, these bone cells, they are embedded in the hard matrix. Okay, means they are made up of hard matrix, and they are having two important elements, that is calcium and phosphorus. Okay, so the compounds of calcium and compounds of phosphorus, they mix together and they form the bone, which is a hard substance in the body. Two bones can be connected to each other by another type of connective tissue called the ligaments. Okay, now see, in our body so many bones are there. Okay, in our skeleton so many bones are there. Now how these bones are connected to each other? So these bones, they are connected to each other. How? By a particular connective tissue. Okay, there is another type of connective tissue which connects two bones, and that is called as ligament. Okay, so what is the function of ligament? It connects two bone. This tissue is very elastic and has considerable strength. Now this ligament, okay, ligament, it is elastic, means it is having the property of elasticity, same as rubber band. Okay, so what happens, this because of its elastic property, it gets stretched, okay, and it gets relaxed, and it is having the strength also. Ligaments contain very little matrix, so the amount of matrix which is present in ligament, it is very less. Another type of connective tissue is tendons. Okay, now there is one more type of connective tissue which is called as tendons. So tendons are fibrous tissue which connects bones to muscle. Tendons, this is another type of connective tissue. What it does, it connects bone to muscle. See here, what is the function of ligament? Ligament connects bone to bone, whereas this tendon, it connects bones to muscle. So these tissues, these are two types of tissues are very important, okay, and it is the part of compact bone. Okay, now moving to the next part, that is they are with great strength but limited flexibility. Now these tendons, okay, they are having the great strength, okay, they are having more strength, but they are having limited flexibility. Okay, see here, ligament, it is having the flexible property. Why? Because it is having elasticity, whereas this tendons, okay, it is having limited flexibility. Now moving to the next part, that is hyaline cartilage. So here you can see the structure of hyaline cartilage. Okay, now this hyaline cartilage, they are widely spaced cells. Now look in the picture, look at the picture, and you can see that this is the cells. Okay, these are the cells. Now in between cells, there are so many spaces are there. Okay, so what it says, it shows that they are having widely space, means so much space is there in between the cells. The solid matrix is composed of proteins and sugar. Now in this, the matrix is solid. Okay, in this, the matrix is solid. So this solid matrix, it is made up of what? Proteins and sugars. Cartilage smoothens bone surface at joints. Okay, now this cartilage, what it does, it smooths the bone. Okay, it smooths the bone surfaces at the joints, wherever the joints are there. Okay, if you check your knee or the shoulders, okay, so wherever the joints are there, over there the cartilage, it smooth the surfaces. It is present in the nose, ear, trachea and larynx. Okay, so when you check your nose, okay, it is easily like you can move it. Then ear, you can move it. Okay, why it is so? Because cartilage is present. Even it is present in trachea and larynx also. Now moving to the next part, that is blood cells. So here you can see the picture of blood cells. Okay, so this is the blood vessel, okay, which is a tubular structure. Okay, we are not worried about these things because this is a blood vessel. Okay, it is a tubular structure where the blood is flowing. So in this we are having white blood cell, red blood cell and platelets. So here you can see this structure, it is called as platelets. This is called as red blood cell and this is called as white blood cells. So blood has a fluid liquid matrix called plasma. So blood, it is having liquid matrix. Okay, so in our previous case we have seen that it was having solid matrix. Over here it is having the blood is having the liquid matrix. In this, okay, again we are having various types. So blood, it is having red blood cells, okay, it is called as RBCs, white blood cells, that is WBCs, and the platelets. So these all are suspended in the plasma. So here you can see, okay, so here we find all these three various types. The plasma contains proteins, salts and hormones. What all essential things are present in plasma? The plasma contains proteins, salts and the hormones. Okay, they all are suspended or embedded in this blood. Next, blood flows and transports gases, digested food, then hormones and the waste material to different parts of the body. Now, what is the function of the blood, or what is the importance of blood? Now, the gases, that is exchange of gases, carbon dioxide and oxygen, it takes place by blood. Then digested food, the food which we are eating, okay, those are digested and they are transported in the body. But how they are transported? With the help of blood. Okay, now our body produces waste products, okay, waste materials are produced. Now in the whole body, how it is collected? It is collected by the blood. Okay, so what is the important function of blood? It helps in the transport of gases, it helps in the transport of digested food, it helps in the transport of hormones, and along with that, it helps in the removal of the waste materials. How it is removed? By collecting all the waste material from the all the part of body. Okay, now moving to the next part, last part, that is nervous tissue. So here you can see the structure of neuron. Okay, so this neuron, it is having a typical shape, okay, a kind like irregular shape. So it is having a cell body, this is called as cell body. Now this cell body, it is having a branches, okay, this branch, okay, it is called as dendrite. Okay, it is called as dendrite. In between the cell body, okay, we find a round structure, it is called as nucleus. And one of the dendrite is elongated, okay, it is elongated tube like structure. Okay, and at the structure, tube like structure, some different structures are there. Okay, it is called a sheath. Okay, and over here, axon, and the ending part of this nerve, it is called as nerve ending. Okay, this is called as nerve ending. Now let us see what is this. The cells of nervous tissue are highly specialized, and the cells of this tissue are called nerve cells or neurons. Now see, the cells of the nervous tissue, okay, they are highly specialized. Okay, they are having a particular function, and they are very special. Okay, so the cells of the nervous tissue, they are called as nerve cells, or they are also called as neurons. Now why they are having special, why they are highly specialized, what is their important function? Let us see. Nervous tissue stimulates and transmits the stimulus very rapidly from one place to another within the body. Okay, now what does this nervous tissue do? Now whatever messages has to be passed within the body, okay, it is transmitted very rapidly. That is too fast. Okay, it's like your mobile. Okay, now you are sitting in your home and I am over here, so whatever I am teaching, it is going directly to you at a fast rate, that is very speed. Okay, so the same thing happens over here. If I take a pin and prick your hand, okay, then what will happen? You suddenly take out your hand. Why is it so? Because the message which I pricked your hand, it will pass through the nervous tissue, it will go to your brain, and from the brain the message will come that you have to take out your hand immediately. So this will take within fraction of seconds. So this message which is passed within the body, that is transmitted within the body, it is because of nervous tissue. The brain, spinal cord and nerves are composed of the nervous tissue. Now what all parts are present in the nervous tissue? That is brain, spinal cord and nerves. Okay, nerves. Okay, next. A neuron consists of a cell body which comprises of nucleus and cytoplasm, from which long thin hair like parts arise. So as we had discussed before, so this is a cell body. Okay, this cell body, it is having a nucleus. Okay, and in the cell body, cytoplasm is present, and this cell body, it is having some hair like structure. Okay, the neuron has a single long part called the axon, which transmits the nerve impulse to body parts. Okay, now this cell body, okay, it is having a long structure or long part, it is called as axon. Okay, it is called as axon. Now what is the function of this axon? It transmits the nerve impulse to body parts. Means whatever signals are there, it is passed or transmitted by axon. The neuron has a short branch parts called dendrites. So here you can see the cell body, it is having various branch-like structures. These are called as dendrites, okay? Many nerve fibers combine together by connective tissue and form a nerve, okay? Now see here, this is one neuron. So there are millions of neurons are there which are connected to each other, okay? Which are connected to each other to form the nervous tissue. Nerve impulse enables animals to move rapidly in response to stimuli. Okay, now whatever action is carried out by the animals, okay, those responses, these are carried by because of the stimuli. Okay, stimuli, it is one of the action given, okay, and animals response for that. For example, I said if I prick your hand with the pin, that is the stimuli and you will give response for that. Okay, so this is the response to stimuli.